Thank you, Jesus.
And God fought him every day, but God delivered him, if not into his end. Verse 15, which is the last verse. And David saw that Saul was come out to seek his life, and David was in the wilderness of sin, in a wood. May the Lord bless his word for the salvation of our soul. You are welcome to see all your free by now. Please call us.
Thank you.
Your kindness never ends.
when I used to do it in school, there's a song we sing, Peter, don't go like that. All right, let's pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you so much for your presence in our midst here.
We
also thank you because you are present wherever we are listening to you now. As we gather together to eat from your table, I pray you will feed us to satisfaction. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I pray what you are revealing to us today will help us to manage our fears of this world of human beings in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we pray for as many who are to be here, but something is keeping them there. That Holy Ghost will clear the way for them, and will run in here and join us in this meeting. In the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you for hearing our prayer. In Jesus' precious name, we pray. Almost the last lap of our worship service today. I welcome those who are also watching us all over the world right now. Today, we are continuing with our study of the book of 1 Samuel. And if you have been following us, you will see that so much to learn about David's experiences with the enemies. You know, Saul, in the last study we had last Sunday, destroyed many men of God who could not want it in the beginning. I hope the men of God in Nigeria here and other places to begin to tell those who are mismanaging the world, mismanaging people to do the right thing. Talking to the people of government. Now, today we are continuing from 1 Samuel chapter 23, verse 1 to verse 2. And what we are considering, as we have heard from the members of the choir, God's abiding presence in time of trouble. You know, David was really in trouble, great trouble.
David is one in which should
he has left his family.
What if he had been still
and a number of people who saw his problem had to join him.
And one of the people who saw him, what are for more?
And they said they are going to support him.
One in a number of people.
So he was now living a life of no parents, no close family. Was just with people who are dissatisfied with
him.
You see, human beings are the people that Satan uses. That's what many of you don't understand. When you see somebody making trouble with you, it's Satan that is pushing it. And that's why you don't need to fight that person. What do you do? Go to God in prayer. That's why before we go deeper into this story, we're going to look at point one today.
And
I want to see who a man is first. Because we are going to see as it affected David here. So, number one point we are looking at is the fallibility of man. Still, we are always a failure. We are not perfect. That's why the topic, subtopic one, is the fallibility of man. You know, when you have this understanding that man is not somebody to rely on, your disappointment will almost be like zero. Because you know that this is my wife, this is my husband, this is my children, this president, all of the people who are human beings, they are not perfect. That's life. There's nothing you can do about that. The only person that can make one not to be fallible, that is, to be perfect, is Jesus, God.
And come see fully that has been alone.
The only person that can make one not to be fully bold is Jesus.
And come to fully that can be your journey or only Jesus.
He designed your life. He's a new creature. All things are passed away and all things have become.
So she said, okay, and you can come out and we see what is there. That's
so we're going to look at this fallibility of man now. I'm going to read from 1 Samuel chapter 23, verse 1.
I can Samuel from 23. That's a second.
They told David, say, behold, the Philistines fight against Keila, and they rob the threshing floors. Therefore, David inquired of the Lord, saying, shall I go and smite this Philistine? And the Lord said unto David, go and smite the Philistine, and save Keila. And David's men said unto him, behold, we be afraid here in Judah, how much more then, if we come to Keila, against the army of the Philistines. Then David inquired of the Lord yet again, and the Lord answered him and said, arise, go down to Keila, for I will deliver the Philistines into thy hand. Verse 5. So David and his men went to Keila and fought with the Philistines and brought away their cattle and smote them with a great slaughter. So David saved the inhabitants of Keila. Look at David in his own trouble here.
Now, what David did you show us to me?
He had that for people who have problems.
And
the Spirit of God in him thought that, let us go and deliver these people. Say they are children of God. When they have problems, anybody that comes their way, they are going to fight. Don't you know I have a problem? I mean, just because they have problems, what David is not like. Come and see some men. If maybe they have not paid them salary in the place of God, And they come home, the wife says, welcome. What welcome? Eh? The children will even want to go. You will tell them. Why? Because they have not paid the salary.
You mean, if you don't think she shall ever take the wash? So, by the way, I'm going to sleep on my mom, I am. I'm going to have a dream of mom, I don't want to. It is. So, if I'm going to take the wash.
Even in the church, if we discipline somebody, you did something wrong now, and we discipline you. If the person is going around, you greet him or her. All these are Christian. What do I do? Because most of us, we really don't understand Bible. You
mean God, Toba Pari, Nimi Jolo, Toba Ri, Toba Man Lole, Toba Tse, Ki Apo Mamo Meni Pe, Ki Nibi Tse Yifoma Pari, Awa Kiseni, Awa Tse, Ngo Nibi Peri, Juju.
Some of you here, if they correct you, some of you, they are not going to talk again. So don't be quiet. Why? Because you know, so many things, until God
works
in all. We continue with what attitude. Until you have to send women, two women, to go and beg them. Why you not coming to? Because they
disagree.
Please, you have to change. The problem is there. Does not mean the Spirit of God has left you.
The issue was what's the best? You too much to be fair and you're alone.
Look at David here.
But David didn't be here.
Do you know what has just happened before this one happened?
But don't defend the shell.
David, Saul, they had just killed all the prophets. 85 of them, they had just killed them.
Saul, what's your father? 85, what's your father?
And that is enough to put fear in David.
Yeah, so lots of people will see that everything.
But when they heard that some people of God, Palestinian people, they are trying to trouble them, you know, the good spirit in me came upon it and said, let us go and defend them.
So we pray, I won't pray, don't you call, I won't go long. If you're long, so many do it. Only call on the money jam.
See, trouble must not make you to become a liar or a lioness. Still love your wife. Still love your children. If you are corrected here, don't fight off. It's part of how you can grow. And if they don't pay your salary in your place of work, you pray, they will pay. You can't say because of that, you'll be fighting everybody. Your children cannot even come near you to say, Baba, welcome. Let everything change from now. Because this problem will go after prayers. That's what God expects of us, to show love. Even in time of trouble.
That's
something from David here. He prayed to God. Before he decided to go and help those people. Before you take any action in your life, always seek the face of God. I made a mistake like that one day in my life. So the husband came to me.
And the
woman was pregnant. I think it was the husband that was born again. Maybe I did not understand the time. So the husband
wrote
to me that you give to deliver because I know how I pray with them before they deliver because placenta do not, you know, come out. But the placenta wanted to come out before the child. So it was a real problem. I don't think that the wife will eat and themselves.
So tie up at the
That's why I ran home and I told mommy, I said, mommy, please, we prepare food, you know, and let him carry the food to them, you know, to the woman.
She lady here was a fire open, but for purpose to check, that's the one I want to know.
If I know, I feel afraid. I didn't know I was going to put myself into trouble. So, by the time they gave the woman the food, and some other believers, I just told them that who are around me can also help this family. I didn't know I was putting myself into
trouble.
So, when I want to greet them now after the food,
that's
how I went there. The woman began to force me.
You think
we are poor people? I'm telling people to gather food for them. What will I say now? It was not my mom told me that things were not fine. I don't know what the husband told her. That's how the woman began to walk. Even though I frustrated, I said, I go after you. You know, when you don't pray sometimes, we make some mistakes. Even to help
me. See,
if you don't pray, you will lose money and you will lose many things. My younger brother, I hope, I don't know whether he's hearing me. One day he will hear. Because I did not pray, I just said, I simply collected my 3 million. My brother, if you don't pray, you will lose. I'm talking from experience. David prayed, he inquired, God, this help I want to go and render, shall I go?
That's why
I encourage you to pray.
And if you don't
look like you are praying now. If you can't pray even when prayer is going on, how will you pray when you need to go and help or to go and invest? Who pray now? So you pray to God. And God says to go. That
he
will smile in
Philistines.
So David now called his people, say now they who join him, let's go and do the fight.
David, you want to make our tongue, what we make for you, and that's a
slight little bit. David, what are you saying?
Only David, you know, sir.
They all told him, what are you saying?
We want to suffer David, you know, sir.
And when Judah here, we are afraid.
Our little Judah here, I am very.
Now, you want us to go to Gaza, where Philistines are there. Okay. We can't do it, we can't go, we are not going home.
Now, if you are like, you are not going home, you are not going home.
Now, David did not say, because I've heard from God, we just threw away what these people said.
David was talking to him, but he was talking to him, but he was talking to him.
What did he do?
He was talking to him. He
went to God again and prayed.
What did he do? He was talking to him.
Prayer. Look, I know what's point all of you, both of you, that you are used to going to prophet, going to all these liars, pray for me, see vision. You can't pray yourself.
And
that's why they are making your life a mess. You can't pray. And
it is
that many of you carrying to this church. You can pray.
And
me that is here. I'm not a prophet of rice and beans, a merchant prophet. I don't do business here.
Here
we have to pray.
The
Bible didn't tell me to look unto pastor or to prophet.
He said,
look unto Jesus, the author and finisher of my faith.
He said, you're looking for Jesus.
So come here and be looking at me. Already zero for you, zero.
You have to look unto Jesus.
That's why we are saying, pray. Now, David had to go back to God in prayer that still these people are saying they are not confident. What should I do? And he prayed to God again. And God said, still, go. The people. And they want the battle.
What's the problem? No.
My sister, if you begin to pray, you will see that your life will change. My brother, if you begin to pray, I mean, you don't depend on pastor, you know, preacher. Look, you will deal with God directly. You will see answer. You see your life will be better. What has knowing the whole world is following these blind people they call themselves pastors. They use juju power, occultic power to perform miracles. I think that's why many people are following them.
Well,
after the miracle, occultic miracle, Is there any healing? Check up all over the world. Benny Hinn is a miracle worker. TB Joshua is a miracle worker. The report we have is the people they say they pray for. It is that same sickness that kills them. It's the same sickness that killed the people. The former president of Ghana, Akka, you know, this man, TB Joshua said he prayed for him. It is the same sickness that killed Akka in Ghana. So don't be deceived by all their lies. It's no miracle. They are just deceiving you. Learn to pray. If you go to Nigeria, what we are seeing here, and some other countries that I've traveled to in my ministry, you know, when I was in Dipala, see all these people. They need to go and rent people to come and act. Come and act blind person. Act lame. And then they pay them. And you think that there's any miracle. It's a lie. So, you need to be sensible now. You need to start your life afresh and enjoy the best of God. Now, let's see from verse 6. And it came to pass, 1 Samuel chapter 23 from verse 6. And it came to pass when Abijah, the son of Ahimelech, fled to David to Keilah. And he came down with an ephod in his hand. And it was told Saul that David was come to Keilah. And Saul said, God has delivered him into my hand, for he shot him by entering into the town that gates and bars. And Saul called all the people together to war, to go down to Keilah to besiege David and his men. And David knew that Saul secretly practiced mischief against him. And he said to Abiathar, the priest, bring hither the ephod. Then said David, O Lord God of Israel, thy servant has certainly heard that Saul seeketh to come to Keilah to destroy the city of my sake. Will the men of Keilah deliver me up into his hand? Will Saul come down as thy servant has heard? O Lord God of Israel, I beseech thee, tell thy servant. And the Lord said, he will come down. Verse 12. Then said David, will the men of Keilah deliver me and my men into the hand of Saul? And the Lord said, they will deliver thee up. Then David and his men, which were about 600, arose and departed out of Keilah, and went whithersoever they go. And it was told Saul that David was escaped from Keilah, and he forbear to go forth. And David abode in the wilderness, in strong hope, and remained in a mountain in the wilderness of Ziph. And Saul sought him every day, but God delivered him not into his And verse 15. And David saw that Saul was come out to seek his life. And David was in the wilderness of Ziph. You know, one of the prophet's sons that escaped. His name is called Abiathar. He ran to David. And when he was running, he carried the ephod. This thing they used to, God gave them to pray through to him, to hear his voice. That's what God designed for the prophet at that time. Now, this man brought it along and ran to David. And David said, don't worry, you'll be with me. Saul cannot touch you. And so, he was one of the people following Saul.
David
had that David was in Keilah.
Saul,
he now decided to gather the soldiers and say, hey, let's go and arrest him there. You know, Saul, his eyes now is killing because he has killed 85 prophets. Plot. He is ready to kill David now. Serious matter. Now, as David heard that this man is coming, you know, I need to check on these people that I help. If David Saul came here, would they release me to him?
David wa gbo pe Saul lo gbo won ba wa ni awon to wa ni bi bayi pelu mi ta ba ba ti Saul ba deba se ko le fi mi fun Saul
because they are just happy Keila people
so yi pe won ti mo won won mu awon awa ilu Keila
David help Keila people
David mo awon awa ilu Keila
fight against the Philistines
lati jagun si awon awa Philistines
and they defeated the Philistines
won si gori awon Philistines
but I mean, if somebody does such a good thing for you, if an enemy is pursuing you, does it make sense to hand over that person to the enemy?
See your body show to that for me. See your father lay show over one. Then you know what you're paying for. You're not paying for what I
eat. Now, because the Spirit of God was upon this man called David.
You mean you're not what you're paying for? You're not paying for
what you're paying for. You know, when you have the Spirit of God, you will listen intelligently. You won't be reasoning like a satanic pastor or a satanic prophet. No. Your reasoning will be sensible, will be apt, you know, will be touched up. I mean, super. And when he helped this man, he helped the interpretation of dream that Joseph helped him to understand, got him back his job with Pharaoh.
Oh, Joseph, wow, I know. What happened to you? What was that for that? You to share, not a Pharaoh.
And Joseph told him, remember me when you get there, because they put me in this prison, I didn't do anything, you know.
Joseph, what's up? I want to see you. Look at you. I never say what I'm missing. It's too big. You don't
forget.
For
2 years.
For 2 years.
He didn't remember it.
What's it?
You know, that woman paid for you.
In your way for you.
Don't put hope in any woman being.
This is when.
Not that you're a believer.
This is that you don't even go.
It's God.
It's what you call on.
If not God, this man will not remember. He will never remember Joseph. Let me show you another example. In 2 Chronicles chapter 24.
You know, Chronicles 24.
I want to show you another case. Because many of you, you have lost out because of expecting something good from a man or a woman.
Second
Chronicles chapter 24. I'm reading verse 22.
That says
Thus, Joash, the king, remembered not the kindness which Jehoiakim, his father, had done to him, but he slew his son. But when he died, he said, the Lord looked upon it and required it. Here was a man called Jehoiada. Look at chapter 23 of this second Chronicles. If you read verses 1 to 3
there,
you will see that the king in Israel at this time, it was that elder man Jehoiada who was a priest that made him to be a king at that time.
But
the one that defeated a woman, a witch, Ataliah, witch. This Ataliah happened to be the mother of Jezebel, you know, and he took over the government of Israel by force. So it was Jehoiada, priest, that organized and they made Joash, a small boy, 8 years old, they made him a king in Israel.
Joada, Russia to me, Joam, Papi Joasi, or to me, Chila, Nikana, that's Joba.
Now, Joada died eventually.
Joada, you are cool.
Joash remained a king.
Joash, he was the other.
And the son of Joash, his name is I don't have the name now, but he noticed that Joash was no longer obeying the word of God. And so this boy now said, look, my father never taught you this evil you are doing. You know that this king will not remember what his father, the father of this boy, he gave the boy. And when the boy was dying, he said, well, God will look into this matter and solve it and judge. Can you imagine what this king did here now? That is the proof that you can't rely on human beings. Look, when you are dealing with all these people who say they are men of God or believers, people under them, you have to be careful. This past one, they are members. That's the leader that is going on in government in Nigeria. They belong to all these churches. The members of these foolish churches, they are the people stealing in government.
They are like their father,
because their father, their pastor, their chief, and their members, they are following this method of stealing. So if you want to do business with them, whether they are from Redeemo, whether they are from First World, whether they are from what is their name, any church in Nigeria, I don't give a damn about them. Be careful before you do business with them. They are part of their members.
Because
they are all keys.
So we call it.
Okay. If they want to argue with me, in this country, one that is called evil is a pastor in the day. He stole all the money in the bank. How can you tell me that one is not from? It's from the day. In fact, they send him to jail. They have to pay some money. That's why. But he's still a prisoner.
The same thing,
there's another one. I mean, people laugh in Nigeria here. You know, there are too many things here, from this religion, and from this, what is this called? Winner's Chapel. There are too many here, teaching. This one too, Akinbola, that guy stole money like that. And now, he has a case in the court. There are many here. That's why, look, if you want to do business, be careful, all the churches, they are pastor and they are member. Otherwise, what I'm doing is what they will do with you. I'm telling you.
So many people that should have made it in life, they have destroyed their life. Look at this Kayla. Don't you know that this Kayla, they are very wicked? Somebody help you to deliver you from any. And now, Saul, because he's the president, the king, you should be able to tell him that this thing you are doing is wrong. But you want to protect yourself. That's the problem. The church must rise. Let us stop this shenanigans and this bad behavior. God is supporting us to fight them now. In Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 9. The heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? These are wicked people, evil hearts. In your business, make prayer an important thing. God will guide you. But before you can have God to be helping you like He helped David, you must surrender yourself to God. It's only one can change your heart and make you a good person. So that you will not be like all these evil people in the world. I close with this to encourage you to give your life fully to Christ today.
First John chapter 1 verse 9.
If we confess our sin, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Now, confess your sins to Him. Confess your sins. I was a sinner before. There are many people here who are sinners before. Committed adultery before. Stole money before. Fought. So, if you say you have sinned, I don't think God can receive you. He will receive you because He received us too. Even if you have committed abortion, He will forgive you. Anything you have done, just say, Lord, I'm sorry. He will forgive you. And you promise me that you will not do anything.
But
I'm talking now, you can be doing that in your heart. And you surrender to Him, not to me, but to Jesus. You will see the change in your life. And I trust God, your life will not be the same. Now
we are
going to rise up to pray.
It's
only one prayer you are praying today. If you have not given your life to Jesus, just do it quietly. Surrender your life to Jesus. But if you have settled it, it's not a matter of 1 hour. It's just within a second. Just say it to God. God will forgive you. And then you become a child. And then you begin to walk with God. You pray this prayer. You will tell God, whosoever that Satan has assigned to mislead me, with the aim
Oh,
you will have understood. Who just said it? Pray any person, you don't have to listen to no one. Because they're going to deal with it. God will knock him off the way. Knock him away from your children. Knock him away from your business. Those of you who are wanting to get married, and then you cannot pray enough. Pray that any wrong man, wrong woman, that want to come my way, go to find my life, knock him out. Pray concerning your children. Pray concerning yourself. Pray concerning your education.
Happy man and happy woman, happy lady, happy man.